Please be seated. On behalf of myself as the pastor of Faith Lutheran Church and on behalf of our Faith Lutheran Church Board of Directors, we want to welcome all of you to Gertie's Rite of Christian Burial. She was a faithful member of our church, attended faithfully every Sunday with Walter, and I hope you noticed that today her casket is lying with her feet at the altar, and she will be with us in worship one last time, as it were. And so we have an opportunity to celebrate her faith and her life with all of you as family and friends. I want you at this time to invite you to take a moment, if you haven't already done so, to put your phones on their vibrate or silent mode so that we can keep the right decorum for the service. I know I forgot to mention to the readers where they're going to read from. In case it's not obvious, it's the pulpit, so please, when the time comes, just go there and you can proceed with the readings. In front of you, there are red hymnals, and we will be using those red hymnals with the numbers marked in your worship folder. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Let's stand as we sing hymn number 801 from the red hymnal. 801.
Thank you.
In holy baptism, Gertie was clothed with the robe of Christ's righteousness that covered all her sin. St. Paul also says, "Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were therefore buried with him by baptism into death, in order that, just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his." The casket is now covered with a funeral pall during our next hymn. We join together in hymn number 748, "I'm But a Stranger Here." Mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God of grace and mercy, we give thanks for your loving kindness shown to Gertie and to all your servants who, having finished their course in faith, now rest from their labors. Grant that we also may be faithful unto death and receive the crown of eternal life through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen. The congregation may be seated as we hear the readings.
Gospel John 14, 1-6. Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, I would not have told you that. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. And you know the way to where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me.
Ephesians 2:19-22. So then, you are no longer strangers and aliens, but you are fellow citizens with the saints and members of the household of God, built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets. Christ Jesus himself being the cornerstone, in whom the whole structure, being joined together, grows into a holy temple in the Lord. In him, you also are being built together into a dwelling place for God by the Spirit.
The Old Testament reading is from
Isaiah, the 12th chapter. Behold, God is my salvation. I will trust and will not be afraid. For the Lord God is my strength and my song, and he has become my salvation. With joy you will draw water from the wells of salvation, and you will say in that day, give thanks to the Lord, call upon his name, make known his deeds among the peoples, proclaim that his name is exalted, sing praises to the Lord, for he has done gloriously. Let this be made known in all the earth. Shout and sing for joy, O inhabitant of Zion, for great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel. Please stand as we sing our next hymn, number 722, Take My Hand and Lead Me. Grace, mercy, and God's peace be unto all of you. In the name of Jesus, our Savior. Amen. Please be seated. For you as a family, and for all of you as friends, in the name of Jesus, our Savior. Amen. I'd like to take a moment to read Gertie's obituary. Gertie passed away peacefully with her daughters by her side at Saskatoon City Hospital, where she received compassionate care during her short stay. She is survived by her four children and their families: Brian, Margaret, Hembroff, Jeff, Lisa, Rhonda, Joni, Evan, Krista, Derek, Marky, Garrett, Adele, Jason, Colette, Jeremy, Corrine, Kelly, Betty, Jim Steinauer, Jeff, Carissa, Julie, Rick, Barry, Marilyn Hembroff, Jamie, Christina, Randy, Ricky, Amanda, Jordan, Barbara, Brad, Dolan, John, Stephanie, Jenna, Andrew, as well as numerous great-grandchildren, her brother Wilby Klimak, and sister-in-law Agnes Hembroff. She was predeceased by her husband Walter, as well as her parents Adolf and Elizabeth Klimak, 8 of her siblings and numerous brothers and sisters-in-law. Gertie was born in the family farmhouse near Inglis, Manitoba. She lived there until she met the love of her life, Walter Hembroff. They built their home together in Russell, Manitoba, and then moved to Davidson, Saskatchewan in 1965. In 1983, Mom and Dad moved to Saskatoon to enjoy their retirement. Gertie had a very strong faith and loved her Lord and Savior. Walter passed away in 2016, and Gertie moved into Luther Tower. She was always a hard worker and loved spending time in her kitchen. And boy, could she ever cook and bake, usually humming hymns while doing so. She loved her grandchildren and kept them supplied with knitted mittens and slippers, as well as making them all quilts. She enjoyed watching the Blue Jays and curling on TV. A special thank you to the staff at Luther Tower Intermediate Care Home for the excellent care Mom received over the past 2 years. My friends in Christ, today we take time to note and to remember the gifts that God has given to Gertie as the result of her faith. And now we're going to take some time just to hear the words of the Lord again and see how they fit in with "Heaven is my home." We sang that hymn, and you probably have already noticed that there's a sort of a theme within this service. The word home or household is mentioned at least once or twice in the readings, in the hymns. The reason for that is, as we met with the family, shortly before she passed away, Gertie said, "I'm going home." And she pointed up. For me as a pastor, I got to be her pastor from 2006 onward. And I got to know what a home that Gertie and Walter had and provided for all, well, for some of you as children and as grandchildren and great-grandchildren. And for you as friends. Their home was filled with love and hospitality. People today talk about the languages of love that a couple can have for each other. But over the years, I've gotten to know people, and I think sometimes those languages of love extend to the rest of their families, too. You know what I'm talking about? Baking is a language of love, because it binds people together. And so her and Walter were here all the time in church. I don't remember the year, but I remember their 50th wedding anniversary. At this altar, they stood and renewed their vows. Now imagine that. They renewed their vows at their 50th wedding anniversary. What a joy that was when they said to me, "Pastor, we'd like to do this." I was kind of surprised because it's been a long time. I can't remember if I've ever done a renewal of vows for a couple who's been married 50 years. That's an astounding thing to do. And they did it because they loved each other. And they did it because it gave witness to the faith that they had in God and the love they had for each other. So, let me come back to Ephesians, the reading from Ephesians. It says this, and you'll pick up the home theme quickly. So then you are no longer strangers and aliens, but you are fellow citizens with the saints and members of the household of God, built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets, Christ Jesus himself being the cornerstone, in whom the whole structure being joined together grows into a holy temple in the Lord. In him you are also being built together into a dwelling place for God by the Spirit. Every home has a structure and it has a foundation. And within that home, there are all kinds of marks of love. The way you set pictures on the wall. All the celebrations that gather when a family, or happen when a family gathers around particular homes. And Walter and Gertie's was such a home. I can't begin to imagine all the celebrations and family times that you had there. But I know this, they would be filled with joy and laughter, and sometimes sorrow, because we seem these days to get together the most at weddings and funerals. That's when we see each other. And it's a time to rejoice and a time to be sad too. But their marriage, and her faith in particular, was built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets, with Christ himself being the cornerstone. Her faith began the day she was baptized as a little baby. And now it continues to flourish, even today, and I'll get back to that in a moment. So I said at the beginning of this service, she's with us in worship one last time. Her feet are here, her head is pointing the same way toward the altar as yours is. She came to worship with Walter every single Sunday. I think she was here, and Walter was probably more than I was, but she was here. She received the forgiveness of sins in Holy Communion every time she received it. She was reminded of the forgiveness of sins and being pronounced loved and forgiven every time she confessed her sins in worship and heard the words of absolution for the forgiveness of sins. Same thing when she was baptized. And when that happens, we rejoice. We rejoice because now she is with the Lord. She is home, as she said. And the other reason, the other thing she told some of you was she was glad to go home because she would see Walter and the rest of her family who's already there. Now you're probably wondering, well, Pastor, how can you be so sure? I can be so sure because the scriptures are so sure. Here's what Jesus said. Don't take my word for it. Take the words of Jesus, who said, "Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's," wait for it, "house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. And you know the way to where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." So, is Gertie in heaven? Absolutely. Please note, it's not because she was such a great mother grandmother, wife, friend. It had to do with her faith. Her faith in Christ. When Jesus died on the cross, he died for Gertie. And by his good work on the cross, God gave Gertie everything that Jesus earned on the cross to her. And those gifts came through her baptism, through Holy Communion, and through the Word of God that told her she was forgiven. These are the gifts that Christ gives to her. And by the way, he gives them to you too. These are for you as well. Believe in Jesus and they will be there for you. Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my house, Father's house, are many rooms. So, what are we left with? People always talk about living for the moment. But there's also living for the dash. And I'm not talking about the DoorDash. I'm not talking about the only dash that really matters. It's the little dash between your birth date and your date of death. That dash matters. Because you're not just living for yourself. Gertie didn't. She lived for you as a mother, as a grandmother, and a great-grandmother, and a faithful friend she loved. And she showed it, not just with words, but with actions. All those suppers she made, all those baked goods, and Christmas treats and candies that she made for you were acts of love on her part. And the thing she gave the most was not those fancy gifts, but rather her time and her love. Her smile was infectious. The picture that's on the bulletin and in the obituary, that's a wonderful picture. She looks fabulous. She looked good today. And now every time we celebrate the goodness of her love, we remember that God has given her these gifts in Jesus for her. The Old Testament reading from Isaiah 12 says, "Give thanks to the Lord, call upon his name, make known his deeds among the peoples, proclaim that his name is exalted. Sing praises to the Lord, for he has done gloriously. Let this be made known in all the earth. Shout and sing for joy, O inhabitant of Zion, for great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel." Her strength and her song was Jesus. And her and Walter would come, and they would be part of our congregation every Sunday to celebrate the good gifts that God had given. So the dash I was talking about, all of us are thinking about that dash right now. Some of you are at a later point in life where you're thinking about what that dash will look like after you're gone and when your family gathers on a day like this for you. We think about it in intangible ways. We think about the legacy that we want to leave behind. We prepare a will so that our families can be provided for. That's one kind of a legacy. There's also the legacy that Gertie left behind for you. And I'm not talking about the stuff in the will. I'm talking about the stuff that she did in her life, the faith that she was given by God, that she celebrated every Sunday in worship. That legacy of faith lives on. And today, in a few moments, you're going to gather for a time of fellowship. Well, we all will. And we will reminisce and remember and laugh about all the good things. And we might even cry about the things that made us sad. But we're all going to point to her faith and her life as someone who believed strongly in God and understood the love that God had for her. The other hymn, one of the hymns that we sang was, "Lord, take my hand and lead me." We Lutherans have been singing that hymn at funerals forever, because it talks about what is to come. And later at the end of the service, we'll sing "Abide with Me." What a phenomenal hymn that is. And I want you to read the words when you sing. Take those words to heart, because they talk about abiding in Christ. And Gertie abided in Christ big time. To abide is to rest, to take refuge from the storms of life. It's in the Greek, which is the original language of the New Testament. It's a nautical term that means shelter in the harbor. I don't know what you're going through right now. Maybe your health is changing as you listen to this. Maybe you're going through relationship difficulties. Maybe there's something else on your heart and your mind today. I don't know what those are, but I know this. I know that the Lord will watch and keep you in the same way that he watched over Gertie her whole life. She was clothed in the righteousness of Christ. And when I asked the family if they wanted to have the funeral pall, I was pleased in my heart that they said yes. Because the pall, this drape that covers over the casket, is one final reminder that our lives are in Christ, that we are covered over with the righteousness of Christ, and his love gives us strength. His love in Christ and his righteousness is what we get to stand with clothed on the day of judgment. For God will look at us through these robes of righteousness and declare us forgiven. That's the wonderful good news of the gospel of Jesus Christ. And so this pall reminds us that we are covered, not with everything we can do well, but what God has done for us in Christ, for us. And so God comes to us this day. My friends in Christ, the next few days are going to be hard, because family is going to go back home. And so somewhere between 7 to 10 days from now, it's going to hit you that Gertie has passed away. There will be more tears. There will be sadness. But please remember the sure and certain hope that we have in Christ our Savior, that when the time is right, the resurrection of the body will happen, and we will be at one with our friends and neighbors who have gone before us in the faith. And so, the rest of this afternoon, let's take time to love each other and to celebrate the goodness that God has given to you as a family through Gertie. And for you as friends as well, to celebrate the faith that God gave to Gertie and the love that she had for you. Amen. And now the peace of God that passes all understanding will guard and keep your hearts and minds in him forever. Amen. We confess our Christian faith. God has made us his people through our baptism into Christ. Living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He ascended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. And believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We listen to the musical offertory. Thank you. the dead. Almighty God, you have knit your chosen people together into one communion in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Give to your whole church in earth and in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. Lord, in your mercy, grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to newness of life, and so pass with him through the gate of death and the grave to our joyful resurrection. Lord, in your mercy, grant that all who have been nourished by the holy body and blood of your Son may be raised to immortality and incorruption and seated with him at your heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy, give to the family of Gertie and all who mourn comfort in their grief and a sure confidence in your loving care, that casting all their sorrow on you, they may know the consolation of your love. Lord, in your mercy, give courage and faith to the bereaved, that within the communion of your church, they may have strength to meet the days ahead in the assurance of a holy and certain hope and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those whom they love who have departed in the faith. Lord, in your mercy, help us, we pray, in the midst of things we cannot understand, to believe and find comfort in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Lord, in your mercy, we give thanks for Gertie and for all the blessings you bestowed on her in this early life, earthly life. Bring us at last to our heavenly home, that with her we may see you face to face in the joys of paradise. Lord, in your mercy. O God of all grace, you sent your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, to bring life and immortality to light. We give you thanks. By his death, he destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection, he opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Strengthen us in the confidence that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, will be able to separate us from your love, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Taught by our Lord and trusting his promises, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The Nunc Dimittis is the song of Simeon. You'll recall that Simeon was an old, old fellow. And Mary and Joseph came with their infant baby Jesus to the temple to have the infant baby Jesus blessed. Simeon was waiting his whole life to hear and to see his Savior. And this is the song that he wrote or uttered by the gift of the Holy Spirit when he held the baby Jesus and when he saw the Savior. Gertie is now in the presence of her Savior. And perhaps Gertie has sung this song as well, together. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Lord, now you let your servant go in peace, Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people, a light to reveal you to the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Lord God, our shepherd, you gather the lambs of your flock into the arms of your mercy and bring them home. Comfort us with the certain hope of the resurrection to everlasting life and a joyful reunion with those we love who have died in the faith. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Let us pray. Lord God, Heavenly Father, we thank you for the time you have blessed us with to feed on your word and be strengthened and comforted by it. We pray now that in a moment we give you thanks for bringing us together for a time of encouragement and sharing, laughter, perhaps tears, but above all, comfort in each other. Bless the food we're about to receive, that it would strengthen and nourish us. And bless our time together, that we can be filled with encouragement and love for us, for each other in this time. Bless our time together, we pray, and the food we're about to receive. In the name of Jesus, our Savior. Amen. Please stand. Receive now the benediction of the Lord. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and grant you his peace. Amen. Let us go forth in peace.
In the name of the Lord. Amen.
We join together in the hymn, Abide With Me, number 878.